Hey guys, so welcome to Unacademy. So this is the daily summary and analysis of the Hindu for today, that is 21st of March 2017, presented to you by me, Dipanshu Singh, in English. So if you want to watch the same course in Hindi, you can watch that under this link. You can also follow me to get updates of my courses and of my video uploads. And do not forget to rate and review the course and recommend each and every video, which helps us in reaching out to a lot of people like you guys, which will benefit all of you. So the practice question for today is regarding what is Medha as seen in the news recently. So attempt this question by posting answers in the comment sections below. And the answer for yesterday's practice question is that both of the options were correct. This is the third such project undertaken after the National Hydrologic Project 1 and Project Phase 2. And this is the third such project undertaken. And it will be used to improve the ability to forecast floods and reduce vulnerability. Apart from that, do go through other provisions of this project. Might be important from prelims examination. So the first news is very important. Ganga and Yamuna River have been termed living persons by the Uttarakhand High Court. So earlier, New Zealand's river we covered in the previous Hindu summary, Wangunai became the first in the world to be granted a legal human status. And the important thing to note is that both the rivers and their tributaries and the streams are declared as juristic and legal persons having legal rights. So generally, you're not even animals are considered as living entities and living persons, only humans are considered. So now these rivers are considered now as living entities and they have their own legal rights. And Director of the Namami Gange program and the Uttarakhand Chief Secretary and the Advocate General would serve as the parents for the rivers. And would be the human faces to protect, conserve and preserve the river and their tributaries. Now, the green nod which was given to Neutrino project has been suspended by the National Green Tribunal for the INO Observatory project set up to come near the Madiketan Shola National Park in Idukki district because of the possibilities affecting the nearby category of forest, the category A project and the category B project. So do go through and just Google what are the category A and category B projects. So the Minister of Environment and Forest had categorized it as a category B project for which the EIA it was not necessary, and the guidelines laid down by the ministry said that any project that falls within the 5 kilometer from an interstate boundary or within a notified national park or a project has to be considered a category A. So therefore the NGT has noted that this falls under the category A and therefore needs environmental clearance, not under the category B. So it, since it was a near national park, the INO was asked to get a clearance from the National Board for Wildlife. Now, the filling High Court vacancies on war footing. So this is regarding the filling of the judicial vacancy in the High Court is progressing on a war footing because there was no move to increase the number of posts of High Court judges till all the existing judicial vacancies are filled, because there's already a lot of pending vacancies. And the sanction strength of judges is 1,079. And there was an ongoing issue between the government and the Supreme Court regarding the memorandum procedure. And the NGSC judgment in October 2015, which was caused constitutional amendments regarding equal role in the appointment of judges to the higher judiciary. However, the government wanted to retain the power of cancelling the names on the basis of national security. However, the final right is reserved with the Supreme Court and the judiciary. Now, Vodafone Idea have merged to become the largest telecom company in India, making it a 23 billion giant company. So India's largest mobile telephony data service provider will be having 39.25 crore customers. And this is in a war, obviously, with Mukesh Ambani's led Reliance Jio entering into the high-speed data market. Generally, financial condition of this industry, the telecom sector, was not that great and it was at risk and increased the debt to rupees 4.3 lakh crore, leading to a severe decline in government revenues from the industry. And even the poor financial health of the sector, therefore, was one of the biggest reasons for witnessing the mergers. Now, a sign language dictionary will be released in India soon. So it will be first of its kind developed by the Indian Sign Language Dictionary, developed by the Indian Sign Language Research and Training Center, which is an autonomous office under the Ministry of Social Empowerment and Disabilities. And it has both Hindi and English words, will be developed in both print and video formats, which will be a comprehensive dictionary, is therefore a need of the hour to facilitate the communication between the hearing and speech impaired people. And because they face difficulty in communicating, and 50 lakh hearing impaired people, and there are approximately 20 lakh speech impaired people in the country, therefore we get a huge relief and a uniform language from a dictionary. And it will also contain graphic representations of popular sign and legal, technical and medical terms. Now, a Canadian teacher, Maggie McDonald, has won the $1 million Global Teacher Prize at a ceremony. Actually, she was awarded this at a ceremony in Dubai. It was a Nobel-style award set up by 3 years ago by Dubai-based Warke Foundation. And the prize is paid installments and requires the winner to remain a teacher for at least 5 years. This was done given to her for her work regarding a program specifically for girls addressing their issues of pregnancy and high levels of sexual abuse. Now, the other important news from the national page are the Forward Bloc gets a secretary after 65 years. This is a regional news, but the important thing to note is that Forward Bloc was founded by Netaji Subhash Chandra Bose in 1939. And Mr. Ghosh was actually the longest serving state secretary of political party after he was elected state secretary of the Forward Bloc for consecutive fifth time in 2013. So do remember the name, and historically becomes important for history-based question of modern India. Now, bear cubs have been sighted in a Daroji Sloth Bear Sanctuary, which is the biggest in Asia, spread over 82.5 square kilometers and has a bear population of over 100. It's adjacent to a world-famous Hampi site, and it's also having leopards, wild boars, peacock, and over 200 species of bird. Apart from that, Prime Minister Modi will fast-track his visit to Oman because of a possible announcement of a successor who has been presently named as the new foreign minister, because it was necessary to boost bilateral ties, and it has also set up first bilateral infrastructure fund with Oman, and Oman also expressed willingness to invest in an Indian cooperative. And India and Oman have a strong strategic partnership, and Oman was the first Gulf countries to warm up to Mr. Modi and his government in the summer of 2014. And the both countries have also formed a joint front against terrorism in October 2014. And recently, a warming up in ties in Oman has hosted the India-Oman Partnership Conference in Muscat on December 2016. Now, Kishan Ganga of the Menuhin Indus talks. So this talks about the Indus, India and Pakistan begin discussion on the Indus Water Commission. So the Kishan Ganga and Ratle project were not discussed. However, Pakal Dul Lower Kalain Mir for electric plants issues were taken up, and the talks were suspended previously in May 2015 after the Pakistani commissioner objected to the designs of the Kishan Ganga and the Ratle hydropower projects of India. And secretaries of power of both countries agreed to a third-party resolution through the World Bank 2016. And the World Bank also announced last year that the Pakistan and India should hold bilateral talks, and therefore next they would meet in Washington in April regarding the Ratle project. Now, AICT is seeking to make internship compulsory for technical degrees. So this makes the youth more industry ready, provide a set of hands-on skills and experience of the work environment in the industry. So the All India Council for Technical Education, which is the regulator for maintaining norms and standards in technical education, is thinking of making it mandatory. Now, this news is about the efforts which are undertaken for sparrow conservation, because yesterday it was World Sparrow Day, and this is from the state of Odisha, what the local villagers are doing for the protection of vulnerable turtles and also for the conservation of these bird species. So they have designed artificial earthen nest from coconut shells. Apart from that, because of the drastic reduction in habitat due to construction of houses and other things, they are not able to build the nest because of the matchbox-like architecture. So therefore, the people in this area have taken up a project to basically build artificial nests for these sparrows to build their nest. And so apart from that, the other details you can go through this slide. The other news is that from the international page section that the Britain will trigger Brexit process on March 29, making it the first country in the EU to trigger Article 50, which is a section of the Lisbon Treaty, which sets out how a member state could commence the process with negotiations on the European side and basically start the whole process of exiting of Britain from the European Union. And a country will cease to be a member of the EU 2 years after the triggering of the Article 50, and the triggering of this article will take place after a crucial meeting of European heads of government for the 60th anniversary, which will be undertaken of the Rome Treaty. And within 48 hours, the triggering of the Article 50 guidelines will have to be drafted for remaining 27 member states. So apart from that, we'll cover the rest of the details about this topic once we get more news regarding this. Now, this is important that Norway has been ranked the world's happiest country in the UN's United Nations assessment on the World Happiness Report. It was fourth place in the last year's United Nations assessment regarding this report. Apart from that, other top countries are obviously the Scandinavian countries, Denmark, Iceland, Switzerland. Switzerland, apart from being the Scandinavian country, one of the most, one of the countries which has one of the most highest human development index in the world. The main factors to found support happiness have been caring, freedom, generosity, honesty, health, income, and good governance. Apart from that, there are other countries. And important thing to know that the differences in happiness levels had a lot to do with the differences in the mental health, physical health, and personal relationship. And China has made major economic strides in recent year, but its people are actually not that happy, because it was ranked 79th in the study of 155 countries. And this report was released by UN on the International Day of Happiness. It is the fifth such report since the first time it was published in 2012. So do remember this. Now, the other thing is that India has been ranked 122nd in this report, way behind Pakistan, which is a terror-struck country. And the last in the list of this country, 154th and 155th, have been the Burundi and Central African Republic countries. So anyway, the business page news, the cabinet has approved 4 GST bills. So these are the central GST, IGST, Union Territory Goods and Services Taxes Bill, and the Compensation Bill. So do remember about what all they deal with. So CGST deals when there's a levy of a collection of tax on the intrastate supply of goods. The IGST deals regarding the bill makes provision for levy and collection of taxes on the interstate supply of goods and services, both by the central government. GST obviously deals with the intra-UT supply of goods and services. And the Compensation Bill specifically deals with the compensation which will be provided to the state government for a period of 5 years as per Section 18 of the Constitution, 101st Amendment Act of 2016. So do remember what all these bills deal with the levy. Very important. Now, New Delhi and Afghanistan will talk soon to boost trade. So this is obviously regarding the issues which India is facing regarding boosting trade ties with Afghanistan, because there are certain restrictions, because goods cannot move from India to Afghanistan via Pakistan on road, even though India has accession to TIR convention, and Pakistan and Afghanistan have are the contracting parties to the TIR convention. So Afghanistan can use Pakistan territory to transit trade while Pakistan's good can move through Afghanistan to nations bordering Afghanistan. But Pakistan has not agreed to allowing this APTTA for goods from India to Afghanistan, and India is keen to joining APTTA, and Afghanistan is willing, but however Pakistan is not so willing. And India obviously has other strategic concerns regarding CPEC, that will obviously include the areas covering of the Pakistan occupied Kashmir and the Gilgit-Baltistan region. And India depends on other countries, including Iran, basically to send goods to Afghanistan via a maritime and the air route, because obviously Pakistan does not allow, and the trucks have to go empty-handed from India to Afghanistan back. And India is also planning to strengthen air cargo links with Afghanistan. India and Afghanistan trade investment meeting will also consider more support from India to Afghanistan through line of credit. Now, if you look at the bilateral goods trade, which has dumped nearly 22% in India's export to Afghanistan, is around $526.6 million. India's main export items include textiles, pharmaceuticals, tobacco, iron and steel, and electrical machinery. Imports from Afghanistan are mostly fruits, nuts, gums and raisins, coffee, tea, and spices. Now, Reliance Communication Aircel merger has been given approval by the Competition Commission of India because of the merger which was announced in September to create a combined entity with assets worth rupees 65,000 crores. And the company has received approval from the SEBI and the stock exchanges BSE and the NSE. Now, Vodafone is yet to seek final approval from the RBI for not for a payment banks. So there's a particular timeline, because entities that receive it in principle approval required to secure final approval from the RBI after meeting certain norms mandated by the banking regulator within 18 months on receiving the in principle nod. So the 18-month deadline, which starts from the date these entities receive the letters of in principle approval from the RBI, which obviously was in September 2015, ends in March. 11 entities had applied, 4 got the approval. Paytm, Airtel, Commerce Department of Post, and Mukesh Ambani's Reliance Industries, which got the approval for final payment banks. And RBI had mandated that the promoters of the payment bank should hold at least 40% of its paid up capital, and at least 26% of the paid capital will have to be held by residents. And Vodafone India and obviously Idea have recently announced a big merger. So this is it for today's video, guys. I hope you like the video. Please rate and review the course. Recommend each and every video. Thank you so much, and take care. Hi guys, welcome to an academy. So this is the daily summary and analysis of the Hindu for today. That is 22nd of March 2017. And this lesson will be presented to you by me, Dipanshu Singh, in English. We have the same course in Hindi. So that you can do that by going on this link and following me there to get updates on my courses and notification regarding my uploads. Also, please do not forget to rate and review the course. That helps us in understanding that how this course is helping you guys. And also recommend each and every video. It's at the top right, bottom right corner of the videos. So the practice question for today is regarding what is the theme of the 2017 International Day of Forests. Do attempt your questions and mention your answers in the comment sections below. And the answer for yesterday's question is that Medha is the first fully made indigenous train, which was manufactured by the Integral Coach Factory in Chennai and also has installed LED lighting to reduce energy consumption. So moving on, the first page news is that there was a report which says that 88 youth actually took to militancy in 2016 because of a lot of unrest in Kashmir. There was a terrorism-related problem, obviously, and after the encounter of Hizbul Mujahideen terrorist Commander Burhan Wani, there was an unrest and a lot of protest in Kashmir. Apart from that, there are not a lot of avenues for people and youth there to regarding jobs and employment. So and also these people who radicalize the youth over there have found an opportunity in the name of religion and in the name of terrorism, diverting their minds to militancy. Now, the other thing is regarding the Aadhar, it will be made a must for filing income tax returns and getting PAN card. Already the government is pushing for mandatory services to be availed through Aadhar in spite of Supreme Court's recommendation that it should not be made compulsory, even for availing the benefits under the Pradhan Mantri Kaushal Vikas Yojana for skill development and the self-employment scheme for rehabilitation of manual scavengers, and even for MG Narega benefits and the National Food Security Act, you need to have Aadhar. Now, even for child related program like ICDS, you need to have Aadhaar number or enrollment number for Aadhaar to avail the benefits. The next one is regarding environment related news that Odisha state felled more than 6 lakh trees in 6 years for road projects. So in spite of the fact that the forest cover in the state has actually gone up by 25% in the past decade, Keonjhar district has been worst hit with 94,000 plus trees felled, and then the Kalahandi district lost approximately 62,000. These are the affected districts, and the concern is that most of the trees were a habitat for wildlife. They were used to sustain wildlife. The new trees which are planted are of exotic and fast growing variety, and it's not very much sure that they will survive for a long time. Now, the other news is that the Supreme Court has questioned the government regarding the note ban flip-flops, because earlier the government said that the people can submit their old notes till 31st of March 2017, but then the government cannot arbitrarily close its window to people for its genuine difficulty, and the court directed the center to file an affidavit explaining why it did not choose to extend the deadline. Now, CBSE has mooted for uniform test pattern for class 6 to 8, so it will decide to implement a uniform system of assessment. This will ensure that there is not just an ease of migration of students from one school to another school, but also it will also reduce the difficulties in taking admission in a new school, and also will prepare the students for the higher effort that is required for the upcoming class 10th board examinations. And apart from that, if you're already aware that the Right to Education Act has a no detention policy till class 8th, which was very much in news actually. There was a lot of controversy regarding whether it should be mandatory or should be rolled back again regarding a no detention policy, because Niti Aayog observed that after the no detention policy, there was a drop in the performance level of the students. The next is that the government has defended the army Sahayak system. There was a video released by one of the soldiers in the army in the Sahayaks complaining about stress related issues and employed on menial tasks. But then the government has defended that they actually helped the officers, and they have a clearly defined military duties and form an integral part of the organization structures and have specific functions during war and peace, denying the claims of using them for menial tasks. Now, the central government has rejected joint venture plan for INS Virat to convert it into a museum, and the rejection has once again put the fate of the Centaur class aircraft carrier in question. The proposal was not accepted by Minister of Defence, and the same has been communicated to the Andhra Pradesh government, which has actually applied for turning it into a museum. Now, New Delhi, basically India is ready to welcome Turkish President Recep Tayyip Erdogan for his visit to India in May 2017. This visit will be very crucial because Turkey is an important player in the East Asian region. Some part of it lies in the Europe, and also it's known as the gateway to Europe and is a big market for India. And also, because of the important fact is that Turkey is a member of the Uniting for Consensus group of countries which actually oppose any reforms in the United Nations Security Council permanent memberships. So India will be among the first country, if not the first, also to welcome the president of Turkey after what is being as seen as a controversial referendum, which we already covered in detail in previous Hindu summaries and the editorials, that will make the Turkish democracy more of a presidential democracy, giving more powers to Erdogan for continued term of two consecutive terms. Now, very important news for prelims point of view: India has slipped in human index development index, slipping to a position of medium human development category. It is ranked third amongst the SAARC countries, and Sri Lanka and Maldives, our neighbors, basically rank in high human development category. And the world's top three countries in HDI are Norway, Australia, and Switzerland. And the important basic dimensions for measuring HDI are a long and healthy life, access to knowledge, and access to decent standard of living. Apart from that, South Asia has also had the highest levels of malnutrition in the world and lowest public health expenditure. Apart from that, you can go through the relevant details. Also, I would like you guys to please go through the important components of HDI: multidimensional poverty, gender parity index. So these all reports are important, and what are their components and who publishes these reports is very, very important from prelims point of view. Now, the next one is that the HIV activists are against the four words and they want to be removed from the proposed HIV bill. So the bill basically places an obligation on the state governments to provide treatment as far as possible. So this will not be an obligation for a state, but they will try as far as possible, which is weak and an open interpretation of this statement. And even though HIV bill, instead of protecting and safeguarding our welfare, is now protecting the government, that no one will be denied treatment is a welcome step, but that it does not make any, does not provide any constitutional legal status by introducing this these four words of as far as possible. Now, bill also comes at a time when the national HIV program has weakened due to budget cuts. And India currently faces a nationwide stockouts of diagnostic kits and pediatric formulation of antiretroviral therapies, which are used to treat HIV infections. There was also a news previously in the Hindu summary where we covered children affected with HIV had written to Prime Minister Modi over the syrup, which was whose production was actually stopped by Ciplab due to non-payment of the amount by the Ministry of Health. So the next news is from the national news that NIC will speed up hiring to lift IT security. So National Informatics Center plays a crucial role and is a prime builder of the most of the e-governance platform. There's a requirement and a shortage of people and they will be basically hiring a lot of security experts to build up on the security platform of the nation. IT security platform of the nation. And celebrities will face law for misleading ads. And the complaints will be received through the grievances against misleading advertisement website. So this will there's a proposal to impose stringent punishment for misleading advertisement on manufacturers, celebrities endorsing the products, and the publishers. And the new bill, apart from that, the government had also earlier introduced the Consumer Protection Bill 2015, which was referred to as to the Parliamentary Standing Committee. And the IMB Ministry had constituted an interministerial committee to examine the complaints. So it will also take suo motu cognizance of alleged violations of the program and advertising codes. Now, also do read about the Advertising Standard Council of India and regarding provisions regarding that that can be asked in the prelims examination. Now, the auto LPG body has called for a gas price parity because generally the commercial LPG is taxed much more higher than the household LPG. So there was cases of basically diversion of these domestic LPG cylinders for commercial users, and higher tax rates make auto LPG a less attractive option when it is used. When its use actually needs to be encouraged in terms of the rising global warming and the effects of pollution on the environment. And auto LPG emits about 120 times lesser particulate matter than diesel vehicles,
96% lesser NOx, that is nitrogen dioxide, than diesel, and is 68% lesser NOx than petrol. It is much cheaper than petrol and diesel and is very comparable to CNG. And unlike CNG or LPG, can easily be installed on two-wheelers as well. So this is something new. And emissions from two-wheelers are major culprits for poor urban air quality, and the government must also initiate adequate measures to promote its use. Now, the international page news is that recently, this news came in last night only, that the US and UK have limited electronic devices on planes, so you cannot carry anything else apart from a mobile device, and that too of a particular dimension, not bigger mobiles, not even tablets are allowed in your cabin baggage on the flights due to a possible usage of that as a bomb, as per the threats report by security agencies there. But however, a lot of people have said that this is basically to benefit the their domestic carriers, domestic airline carriers, because this has been made for this provision has been made for flights coming from specific countries, mostly dominated by Muslim and Islamic countries. So that's one of the major concerns, that global players like Etihad and Qatar Airways will face some difficulties, as passengers would switch to other airlines from US or other country to avoid the inconvenience. Now, for the first time, TV matches print in advertisement revenue. So the revenue growth from ads actually slowed down in the English language and print media, but then television has caught up with the print, and the television revenue from advertisement jumped 11% in 2016. However, the print revenue growth actually fell down, but it started to slow down. Even the regional language newspapers performed well, and TV witnessed a slow growth in 2016 in terms of overall revenue. And apart from that, overall Indian media entertainment industry in 2016 was able to sustain healthy growth. And digital advertising continued its high growth trajectory with 28% of growth in 2016. So this is it for today's lesson, guys. I hope you like the video. Please do not forget to rate and review the course and recommend each and every video at the bottom right option over here with that recommendation button. If you have any suggestions, do let me know. If you have any doubts and queries, please post it in the comment sections below. So till next video, I hope you have a good day. Prepare well. Thank you so much and take care.